Good morning all of you. I am Kasthuri from Chemistry Department. I wish to handle the topic of buffer solution. First of all, we have to know what is meant by buffer solution. Buffer solution is one of a solution. It is used to maintaining the pH value even if adds an external strong acids or bases to it. This is known as buffer solution. It has some characteristics. If you keep on standing, there is no change on it. There is no change in pH. Even if you dilute that solution, even if you dilute the buffer solution, there is no change in it. Okay, this is the characteristics of the buffer solution. It is classified under two types. The first one is single substances of the solution and the next one is mixture of the solutions. Single substance of a solution means it is one of the salt containing one weak acid and one weak base of the salt. Example like acetic acid one of the weak acid and the ammonium hydroxide one of the weak base. It is make the salt of ammonium acetate. This is one of the example of single substance of solutions. Next we move on to the mixture of solution, that is the second category. It is further classified into two types. The first one is acidic buffer and the next one is basic buffer. First, we move on to the topic of acidic buffer and its action of it. Okay. Acidic buffer means it contains one of the weak acid and its conjugate base of strong base of the same substance, that is known as acidic buffer. The example of acidic buffer is acetic acid one of the weak acid. The same substance of the conjugate base, that is sodium acetate. These two combination named as acidic buffer. Then we move on to the basic buffer. This same like that the acidic buffer. Here we take the weak base. Ammonium hydroxide of the weak base. This is the same substance of the strong acid, that is conjugate acid. This is ammonium chloride. This make the basic buffer solution. These are under the category of mixture of solutions. Now we move on to the action of acidic buffer and the basic buffer. Action of acidic buffer. What happened here? That is, the weak acid degree of ionization is suppressed by adding the conjugate base of sodium acetate. Here, in the mixture of acidic buffer solution, the acetate ions is more present in that coagulation, because the degree of ionization of sodium acetate is more even compared with the acetic acid. So if you add the external acid, some strong acid like HCl, here we add the HCl acid, it reacts with the acidic buffer solution like H plus, that is the acidic concentration. What happened here? The acetate ion obstruct the H plus and even form that same combination, that is weak acid. It back to form the original, that is weak acid in the acidic condition. If you add the some base, some strong base like sodium hydroxide, in that case the hydroxide ion is react with weak acid of acetic acid, that abstracts the H plus from that weak acid, and after that the water is eliminated from that solution. Then what happened after the removal of water? It returns to form the same, that is acetate ions. This is what happened here. The when even add some external acids or bases to the acidic buffer solution, there is no change in its pH value. It return back to form that acetate ion and also the acidic acid also. Okay, this is the action of acidic buffer solution even when add some external acids or bases to it. Now we move on to the action of basic buffer. What happened here? This is also same like for the acidic buffer. Here the weak base of ammonium hydroxide, degree of ionization is suppressed by adding the conjugate base of ammonium chloride. Here the ammonium ion is more present in that solution than the weak base. Here if you add the same external acids like H plus, what happened here? It is react with the weak base, and after the reaction what we'll get, the water get removed as H2O. The H plus is reacted with ammonium hydroxide. After the reaction, water is get eliminated. Then the same NH4 plus get formed. Okay, then on the other hand, if you add the external base, that is OH minus, to that solution, what happened here? OH minus base, that is OH minus, it is react with the ammonium ion, that is NH4 plus. It return back to form that same weak acid, that is ammonium hydroxide. NH4 plus plus OH minus, it return back to form that same weak base. This is happened simultaneously. If you add some external acids or bases to that basic buffer solution, there is no change in it pH. This is the main action of the same acidic buffer and the basic buffer. Now we move on to the applications of buffer solution in our real life. Application of buffer solution in our living system means there is lot of applications even with the use of buffer solution in our industries or in our real life. Example, the buffer solution is used to preserve the foods and used to prepare some chemicals in industrial applications. It have lot of applications in our day to day life, but I wish to illustrate the application of buffers in our living systems. In our body, there is lot of reaction carried out in our systems, in our regular body system. We have to know that what are the reactions in our body. Okay, with the help of buffer solution, one by one. Okay, uses of buffer in our living system, there is mainly four applications. The first one is bicarbonate buffer system. Bicarbonate buffer system. It contains bicarbonate ions and with the carbonic acid. HCO3 minus, this is bicarbonate ions, H2CO3, this is carbonic acid. These two combination is referred as bicarbonate ions, that is bicarbonate buffer systems. What is its main role in our body system? Bicarbonate buffer system is used to regulate the pH level in our blood system. Okay, what happened here? This is same as the action of acidic buffer and the basic buffer action in its classification. Okay, bicarbonate buffer system, even in blood system, if the acidity is increases, acidity means that is H plus concentration, we already known that. If the acidity is increased in the blood pH level, means what happened here? The CO2, that is in the acid. Okay, CO2 is liberated through the respiration system. Even if increases the H plus concentration level, means the CO2 is liberated through respiration system. In the next case, the basicity, that is OH minus, is increased in the blood system, means what happened here? The bicarbonate ions, this HCO3 minus, is excreted through urine system. So, the bicarbonate buffer is used to regulate the pH level of blood system via the excretion of bicarbonate ions through urine, and also the expel the CO2 from respiration system, even if increases the acidity system. Okay, this is the application of bicarbonate buffer system in our blood. Next, we move on to the second applications, that is the phosphate buffer system. It contains two ions, like bicarbonate buffer system, it contains two compounds. One is hydrogen phosphate ions and the other one is dihydrogen phosphate. phosphate ions. These two combination make the phosphate buffer system. This buffer system is used to regulate the pH level of body cell. Okay, the cell, if the acidity or basicity is increased in our cell system, means the phosphate buffer is used to regulate the pH level. Okay. Let us assume this is a cell in our body. Say, left hand side basicity, right hand side that is acidity. Okay, that is represented as H plus. This is represented as OH minus. If what happened? If the acidity is increased in our cell system, means what happened, means the hydrogen phosphate ion abstract the H plus and neutralize the acidity concentration via the formation of dihydrogen phosphate ions. This is the first action in the acidic condition. Okay, next, in the basic condition, what happened? The OH minus is reacted with dihydrogen phosphate ions. In the case of acidity, the H plus reacted with hydrogen phosphate ions. In the case of basicity, the OH minus is reacted with the dihydrogen phosphate ions. After the reaction, what happened, means the one hydrogen is reacted with this water and eliminated as H2O. And form back to its hydrogen phosphate ion. Okay, this is the main action used to regulate the pH level of cell system. Okay, this is the second application. Next, we move on to the third. Protein means, we already known that, that is the combination of lot of amino acids made to form the protein. In the protein system, what is act as a buffer? That is amino acid. In our physiological system, the amino acid present in the form of two ionic charges. One is carboxylate ion. Stop. Okay. Amino acids is present as two ionic charges. One is carboxylate ion and another one is nitrogen trihydronium ion. These two ionic charges used to regulate the body pH level. If H plus, the same concept, if the acidity is increases in our body system, means the carboxylate ion upset the H plus and return back to form its original, that is carboxylic acid functional group. And in the case of basicity, what happened? The OH minus is reacted with NH3 plus. After the reaction, water is get removed and it return back to form amine, that is NH2. This reaction simultaneously happen in our body system at regularly. Okay, this is the protein buffer action. Next, we move on to the fourth application, that is hemoglobin buffer. Hemoglobin buffer, this is also used to regulate the pH level in our body system. What happened here? He means, that is ion in the hemoglobin system, that is center of the hemoglobin. Globin means, that is the protein. around the ion atom. In our body, the H plus concentration is increases means the H plus is attached with the globe system. The O2 is attached with the hemo system, that is ion system. This is react with simultaneously heme with globin, and it is used to regulate the pH level. If the concentration of H plus is increased means it is attached with globin, the O2 is expelled. If the O2 molecule is increased means it is attacked with heme, that is ion, the H2 is expelled. This the process is simultaneously happened in our hemoglobin system, used as buffer system, used to regulate the pH level in our body system. These are the four application mainly used to regulate the pH level in our body system.